What is up, guys? Welcome back to the Zisms. My name is the awesome J34, and today we are going to be doing my first ever, I think, premium tank review. No, this is not an aircraft. Yes, Japanese tanks can fly. But my first ever Japanese review, and my first ever Japanese premium and or premium review in general. I don't know. Anyways, so today we're going to be focusing on the Chinu 2. Now, this is a recently added premium tank that sits at tier 3 for Japan, and it's relatively mediocre, I would say. I enjoy it a lot, fits my playstyle a lot. Doesn't have a lot of armor, but the real question is, should you buy this tank? Well, I think the stats will tell you whether or not you'll like it. However, some people do have their own opinions. So without further ado, let's just hop straight into some stats. The Chinu 2 sits at rank 3, battle rating 3.7, and is armed with a 75mm Type 5 cannon that comes with 48 rounds of ammunition for said gun. It is also armed with a not-so-coaxial, but I'm going to call it coaxial, 7.7mm Type 97 machine gun that comes with 3,000 rounds of ammunition. Turret rotation speed on this vehicle is 7.4 degrees a second, with the vertical guidance of this gun being 10 degrees down and 15 degrees up. The reload light on my crew is 9.8 seconds, so safe to say 10 seconds. Hull armor for this vehicle, you get 50mm at the front of the vehicle on the upper and lower plate area. The middle plate and top of the vehicle is only 12mm thick, and the underside and firewall of this vehicle is 8.5mm thick. Moving on to the side of the tank, the upper yellow portion is 20mm thick. The lower portion where the tracks are is 25mm thick. We also have this little side plate in between the side and the front plate that is 20mm thick. Expect to be penetrated there a lot. On the rear of the tank, we have 20mm of armor, and we also have 20mm of armor on the back of the side and the back of the turret area. Moving on to the turret, the gun is 22mm thick. The gun steel around the gun nearing the mantlet is 50mm thick. The gun mantlet itself is 50mm thick. The area around the gun mantlet is 50mm thick. The area around that is 50mm thick. And the turret cheeks are 50mm thick. The side and rear of this turret are both 25mm thick. The top of the turret is 12mm thick, and the cupola is 50mm thick. This vehicle weighs 20 tons and has maximum horsepower of 250 horsepower at 2000 RPMs. Maximum speed is achievable at 39 kilometers an hour. Maximum inclination is 41 degrees, and the visibility is 88%. Moving on to the inside of the view of the tank, your transmission is out the front. Like most Germans, it can be lit on fire, and everything else is mostly standard. You have ammo racks in the back of your turret, ammo racks on the left and right side of your tank underneath the horizontal aiming drive, otherwise known as the turret ring. The ammunition for this vehicle, you can only choose one shell, and that is the Type 1 APHE. So this is APHE, so it does get a lot of high explosive filler, so are you able to take out things kind of easily. Now, it gets 145mm pen, which is probably one of the best pens at this tier. Now let's get right into some gameplay. Alright guys, so our first match is on a kind of rare-ish map, but very open and interesting map. The Japanese invasion of Mazdok. I'm kidding. Just normal Mazdok, but don't you just love the Japanese invasion of Mazdok? Or, you know, the Japanese invasion of Tunisia. Just great, man. Anyways, so we're on Mazdok, and we're on the Axis side, which is the northern side of the map. And because of how this map is laid out, it's really best to just find cover, like the B point or the A point, and just sit in it and snipe things. So for the first part of this match, I really won't be doing all that much. Also, if you would like the skin that I have for this vehicle, I will put a link to it in the description below. I really enjoy it, but it's a little low quality. It's a little low quality, but nothing too bad. So, I spy a Crusader over there, don't really gonna do anything about it, because he's behind a hill. Meh. So, Should you buy this tank? Well, in my opinion, if you're an aggressive player like me, but you sometimes learn patience on, like, maps like this, yes, you should. Now, the Cheetah 2, because of its gun, it does have one of the best guns at this tier, 3.7. Well, battle rating and door tier. Because of that reason, I'm gonna call it the Japanese Panzer IV F2. And or Panzer IV G. But F2's better. So, I don't really know how to explain it. Okay, I'll just put this out there. This vehicle has, like, no armor. If you bounce something, you aren't gonna bounce it. You see the turret, not the turret cheeks, but the side of the turret that's slightly slanted out. That is a rather weak point, actually. You'd think because of how the way it's sloped, it would be not weak. Also, I spy a little M2A4 or M3A1 light tank over there. Can't get a shot at him. He's too far behind a hill. I do bounce eventually, but he's too far behind that hill. Anyways, so this vehicle, the cheeks are very just weak. You'd think, even though that they were slanted at such an angle, T-34s, you'd think they would be able to bounce. Also, we get shot, and we fire back. Goodbye, Crusader. But because of the way this thing's turret cheeks perform, the turret's not bouncy at all. I mean, I've had T-34 low pen shots go right into the sides and just blow up my ammo rack in the back. Also, this thing has a massive ammo rack in the back of the turret. I've already shown you it, but actually, I haven't even shown you it. It's a massive ammo rack. It's just stupidly huge. Anyways, let's get back to the game. So, the Crusader managed to take out my engine. However, he didn't manage to do all that much damage. We were able to return fire, and that was the end of him. Now, I'm being super, super cautious, because I don't want to just die by pushing out. Oh no, look, a Crusader. Ka-thing, he's dead. That was easy. So, because of this thing's APHE shell, you can just blow up everything. It's awesome. It's not, this shell doesn't bounce all that much too, so it's nice. Spy another Crusader, fire one, bang. This is also one of the more high velocity guns at this BR. So you can do quite the sniping with this. I've pulled off quite unbelievable shots in this vehicle. I mean, I haven't captured them on camera, so you can call me a liar. But I've captured quite unbelievable shots, and it's amazing. So the Panzer IIIL is pushing up where the M3A1 used to be. I'm not sure if that M3A1 is still there and or if he's dead. I'm going to assume by the fact that something just got lit on fire that he is dying and the Panzer IIIL is dying. Never mind. Anyways. Yeah, okay, there goes the Panzer IIIL. Sherman gets him. Searching across the map. I don't want to get shot inside, but I also don't want to get shot on the front. I'm in a very open spot right now, and I'm searching for that Sherman that killed the Panzer IIIL, but I can't see it anywhere. No, I do think I see something in the bushes over there. Oh, through the trees over there. I try and range it. It's nothing. I think it was either a dead body or something, but then something shoots us. But what shot us? Maybe it was an aircraft. I can't tell. Pushing up even more into or near the A point, I should say. I do not see any enemies, and I am very, very skeptical that there's absolutely no enemies over here. There has to be at least one. Now, we do get there is an attempt to rocket us by a Hurricane Mark 2B, I think it is. But unfortunately, he misses his first rocket. Now, this guy comes back later. You'll see. So, as I'm pushing towards the enemy spawn point, I'm kind of concerned that there's going to be something somewhere. Now, I tried to look where that shot came from, but I overlook it, and it turns out he's a bit farther to my left. I can't see him because he's behind that hill. I just didn't see it when it got fired, so I was very kind of suspicious of that. Now, I'm also looking around in the riverbed, and oh! Turn my camera the other way. There is a Krommie. And there's a bush there. Try and reverse. I'm never going to get that shot on the Krommie. Something shoots us. Turn back. It's a Locust. Fire. He's dead. Right, so the Cromwell now knows where we are because the Locust spotted us by shooting us. Now the crow is trying to push up to get a shot at us, and I make the executive decision instead of trying to fire at him, because he has the better advantage over here, to go down into the riverbed and try and push up on him. Which is exactly what I do. That was really redundant me. Okay. Anyways, Hurricane Mark II shoots down 109E. Kind of unfortunate. I try to drop artillery on a Cromwell. I've had recent luck with artillery. I don't know why. It's just magic. I guess I should also bring this up. This thing is the crew members in this vehicle are a tank, like, all by themselves. But the second you get hit by, like, that's not how I meant to say it. The crew members in this vehicle are a tank. The second your tank gets, like, hit by a bomb, like, everything will die. Like, your engine, your transmission, your gun, your cannon breach, your everything will die. However, the crew members are very resistant to this for some reason. The Cromwell shoots at us, I'm about to push up, fire one, he's down. I look back to see if there's anything looking at us, but there's nothing. Huh. I see something in the road, but it's too late. Hurricane Mark IIB Trop comes back and rockets us that time. Moving on to our next match, we do get the new map of Korea. So I decide for a second that I want to go to the left, but then I think about it and I'm like, well, there's absolutely no one going to the right, and I fear that most of the battle will be on the right. So, as this Panzer IV F2 is turning very slowly, I turn around and start heading towards this area. Now, because of my aggressive playstyle, it's probably not the best idea to push all the way through, but that's what I do instead. So, oh well. I don't know what to talk about anymore. I lost my train of thought. This is not good. Okay, how about I just talk about the map of Korea in general? So, Korea is a very interesting map, because it's a Korean War map that you can see with, like, not Korean things. It's weird. I'm also kind of surprised that they haven't patched a few of the bugs here. You see me looking at the bridge that's over there? That's because you can get on that bridge. I'm not going to tell you how, because I don't want more people on the bridge. But you can get on it. It's possible. Now, I try and get lucky artillery shells judging by where I am and judging by where the enemy team should be. But no goal. Chaffee is my only friend on this flank, and he's going to go up along the upper road portion of that area. Now, I get suspicious because I could have sworn I dropped my arty near B. I didn't hear any bombshells go off, but I did see artillery shells near my point. So, what happened there? Question mark? Now, Cowardice, the Chaffee, says our positions probably won't be able to help cap or defend, but I'm just like, eh, I'm aggressive. I don't know why I said that. It kind of makes no sense, but oh well. So we're pushing through the town here, and I've already made it to the town. Now there's absolutely no one here. I kind of look over to see if there's anyone on my left, and, well, there's no one. I can't see anyone. Until I get shot. Waiting. We push through this area right here. Still looking for people, still don't see anything. Now, there's a Sherman hiding in the bushes. As I'm struggling to get through that fence, the Sherman takes a shot at me. Right now. I'm kind of looking for where he is, because I have no idea where this guy is. He could be on the hill, but nope, he fires, he misses, and or bounces. It's too late for him. Fire one, he's out. So, repairing my transmission. Fun things. It seems to me like this thing's transmission is just a huge block. I don't know why that is, because it's not all that big, but it gets shot at a lot. Anyways, looking over, I see Cowardice, the M24 Chaffee, getting wrecked by something. And or wrecking something. I don't know what he's doing, but I'm going to repair him. I'm going to repair my transmission, I'm going to go help him. 8 seconds, we'll be up soon. Our artillery that I dropped on the thing that is terrorizing or is being terrorized by the Chaffee misses unfortunately, as usual, you know, the norm. Well, at least I get a hit out of it. So, I push around the corner, only to discover what I can't remember. I don't remember what the steward named this guy. So, I'm very, like, just think about it. And, oh, it's a Sherman. I probably shouldn't have taken that kill, because I have the feeling the Chaffee would have had it for himself. I mean, he was burning up and everything, but man's got to do what a man's got to do. Now, the enemy team is capturing the A point now. And instead of going back down and taking the long way around, I think I'm going to take the quick way around the area where the Sherman was to get to the point. Now, the Chaffee also repairs as soon as I get finished with that, and we both start heading towards the A point. And the Panzer IV-H that you can see in the distance over there is realizing the necessity of going to getting to the cap point as well. Now, I see a heavy tank, and I'm suspicious of what it could be. It could be an American, I could be a British, but I'm not sure what is on the enemy team thus far. So, I look right there, like you can see a tiny smidget of him, it's an M6A1, so I'm not really worried about it. I don't want to push down, though, because I think it is kind of a decent tank. And I assume this position. Now, this position would have been good to get a shot at that guy if that tree wouldn't have happened to go there. I try and push up to try and get a shot at it, but it's too late for that. Well, there's absolutely no position over there for that. I don't have enough gun elevation either. But I push back up, and oh, look, a Sherman. Fire one, the Sherman dies. Now, I'm going to try and focus the M6A1 here. And he starts to kind of look at my position, but I'm not sure what he's doing. Fire one, kill only his gunner because, you know, battle bus. Drop Erdi on him. And reload. Fire one. He's dead. GG. Question mark. Also, I like how this has crew knocked out, even though it doesn't show my shell even exploding. None of his crew died there. The shell just went through the tank. Thanks, Gaijin. Now, I'm looking back towards the town because I have been flanked by things coming through back the town quite a few times. It's rather unfortunate. And as I push towards the cap circle, something starts dropping already, but it misses. So the Chaffee's waiting, I'm waiting, and Phantom's waiting. And I can tell you now, this will be the last thing that I achieve this match, is hopping onto the cap circle. I'm not even going to get a capture. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like down below. It really helps me. And if you want, you can subscribe as well, because you know you want to see more of my wonderful content. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave those in the comment section below. I will answer that as soon as I can. I pretty much read all of them. And yeah, now moving on to the question I asked at the beginning of this video. Should you get this tank? Once again, it is completely up to you. If it fits your playstyle, it fits your playstyle. If it doesn't, sorry about that. Anyways, guys, I shall be salty as that F6F5 is the guy that I killed. But anyways, guys, I will see you in the next video. Peace.